We gather as a community of family and friends and feel ripples of excitement and tremors of joy as we celebrate the marriage of William and Delaney. God has created a world of harmony. Soaring birds, towering trees, brisk wind, animals of all kinds, each unique, each in relationship and harmony with the others. God's first gift was breathing life into humans and turning us toward each other to live in equality and unity. William and Delaney have come here to affirm their love for each other and enter into this sacred union. Marriage is a gift. Marriage is an opportunity for love to be learned. Marriage is a journey in which we as the travelers are faced with many choices and responsible for these choices. Marriage is a call to servanthood. Marriage is a call to friendship. Marriage is a call to suffering. Marriage is not an event, but a way of life. Marriage involves intimacy in all areas for it to be fulfilling. Today, William and Delaney, you come together, bring all of you to this marriage, all of your wonderful parts, all of your hurts and pains. You especially bring today all of your hopes and dreams for this marriage. In preparing for today, Delaney, William shared, "I knew you were the one for me because of the way you see the world and how you truly care about the people in it. You're perfect for me because of the way you keep me grounded." And William, Delaney shared that, "I'd like to say I knew you were the one for me the first night we went out, but it was probably when life started throwing curveballs and the way you reacted to them. One story in particular sticks out. My freshman year of college, my car broke down in a sketchy gas station in Jacksonville. And I was full-blown panicking. You got to me so quickly, handled all the logistics of insurance, kept me company, and was even late for work to make sure I was safe. Your consistency and level-headedness are some of your best qualities. At 18, I didn't realize those were traits I was even looking for in a life partner. And now that I'm older, I realize how vital it is for me for our relationship. You're perfect for me because you bring consistency, maturity, honesty, and are truly a gentleman. You have high morals, are a great leader, and are so loyal to those you love. You know I'm a highly emotional person, and you're not. Therefore, you've changed so many ways that you respond to me that is constructive and not reactive. The qualities you bring to our relationship are things I never knew I needed until I met you. You both have tremendous faith in each other, as you trust your future to the other's care. And you have excellent reasons for believing you belong together, but you have no guarantees. Instead, you stand together about to accept on faith the challenge of creating the future together. Faith is the assurance of things hoped for. You marry in faith that God has called you to live as one. You promise to be faithful to one another in big things as well as small. Your constant faith in each other will give form and substance to beautiful hopes you have for your future. Faith is the conviction of things not seen. Unless you're an unusual couple, at times your marriage won't look anything like the vision you celebrate today. You may not feel much evidence of the love you now feel so keenly. At such a time, remember this moment. Remember the hopes and dreams that have been entrusted to your care. Marriage begins with a leap of faith that says, I will, before an unknown and unknowable future. Marriage is about being full of faith or faithful to one another. Faithfulness respects each other's ideas and feelings, keeps each other's secrets, guards each other's dignity, and honors each other in public and in private. Faithfulness is built from 10,000 minute acts of trust and trustworthiness. In such faith, you'll find the fulfillment of all the hopes and dreams you have today. May God bless you both. Amen. William and Delaney, have you come here freely without reservation to join together lawfully in marriage? If so, say I have.
I have.
For God and family and friends, I ask you to affirm your vows to each other as you enter into this covenant of marriage and begin to share all the joys of this new relationship, whatever the future may hold. William, repeat after me. I, William.
I, William.
Take you, Delaney.
Take you, Delaney.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
So long as we both shall live.
So long as we both shall live.
Delaney, repeat after me. I, Delaney.
I, Delaney.
Take you, William.
William.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have in the hold.
In the hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
Better.
For richer or for poorer.
Richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness.
To love and to cherish.
To love and cherish.
So long as we both shall live.
So long as we both shall live.
May I have the rings? These rings are an outward and visible sign of an invisible truth, which binds two hearts in one. As such, they are the symbols of the enduring and unending quality of the love which is now expressed between William and Delaney. Will you repeat after me? Delaney. This ring, is a sign, of my love and faithfulness.
Of my love and faithfulness.
Delaney, repeat after me. William.
William.
This ring.
This ring.
Is a sign.
Is a sign.
Of my love and faithfulness.
My love.
These are the hands of your best friend, young and strong and full of love for you, that are holding yours on your wedding day, as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as together you build your future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear and grief fills your mind. These are the hands that will countless times wipe the tears from your eyes, tears of sorrow, tears of joy. These are the hands that will tenderly hold your children. These are the hands that will help you hold your family as one. These are the hands that will give you strength when you need it. And lastly, these are the hands that even when wrinkled and aged will still be reaching for yours, still giving you the same unspoken tenderness with just a touch. As this knot is tied, so are your lives now bound. Woven into this cord, imbued into its very fibers, are all the hopes of your friends and family, and of yourselves for your new life together. With the fastening of this knot, do I tie all the desires, dreams, love, and happiness wished here in this place to your lives for as long as love shall last. In the joining of hands and the fashion of a knot, so are your lives now bound, one to another. By this cord, you are thus bound to your vow. May this knot remain tied for as long as love shall last. May this cord draw your hands together in love, never to be used in anger. May the vows you have spoken never grow bitter in your mouths. To entwine in love, bound by commitment and fear, sadness and joy, by hardship and victory, anger and reconciliation, all of which bring strength to this union. Hold tight to one another through both good times and bad, and watch as your strength grows. 1 Corinthians 13, 4-8 says, love is patient, love is kind, love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. Please join me for a prayer of blessing over their marriage. God in heaven, you ordained marriage for your children, and you gave us love. We present to you William and Delaney, who come this day to be married. May the covenant of love they made be blessed with true devotion and spiritual commitment. We thank you for giving them strength and courage to keep their vows. Thank you for helping them to create for their family a peaceful, stable home of love as a foundation on which they can build their lives. When selfishness shows itself, grant generosity. When mistrust is a temptation, give moral strength. When there's misunderstanding, give patience and gentleness. When suffering becomes a part of their lives, give them a strong faith and abiding love. Amen.
Amen.
William and Delaney, in the future, happy occasions will come as surely as the morning. Difficult times will come as surely as the night. To say the words love and compassion is easy, but accept that love and compassion are built upon patience and perseverance is not easy. William and Delaney, as much as you've declared your willingness to enter the state of marriage with each other, declare the same in the company of God and these witnesses, by the virtue of authority vested in me as ordained minister and by the state of Florida, I pronounce you husband and wife, united in the pure and holy bonds of wedlock. Where God is joined, let no one separate. Go forth in this life as husband and wife with the blessing of God. Be loving, patient, and kind, and above all, forgive one another, as God has forgiven you. It's my pleasure to introduce to you all for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. William and Delaney Cunningham. William, you may kiss your bride. Okay, it's me. I'm the big swing, I'm a transformer.